To license
Random Radio Discussion Show. Lorenzo Tomas here. I want to thank everybody for being here with us. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Hey, this is our first episode, but, don't you all be afraid. Hey, I have a guest with me. My guest on the show this week, our very first episode, is none other than an artist who has been played on the Random Radio podcast show many times. This is Mr. Culture Freedom. How you feeling, Mr. Culture Freedom?
I'm great. Nice to be out here today talking to the Random Radio podcast show. Y'all, they've been playing my music for a long time, so I really, really am happy to be here. I appreciate you guys having me. Showing me, to be honest, y'all guys were one of the first to show me that kind of love, and then that song blew up, #24. It blew up very lovely behind y'all.
That's awesome. That's awesome. That's good to hear. I do remember that song. It's a Hall of Fame song, if I'm not mistaken. That's a Hall of Fame
song.
Yes,
it is. It's in your Hall of Fame.
That's right. So, that's right. That's a big deal. People don't know that. That's a big deal when you get into the Hall of Fame. It's a big deal. So
well, I was excited about that because, you know, we went for a couple of weeks against some really good songs.
Yeah.
I got some really good songs on this radio station. And then all my friends were listening. I'm still a regular listening no matter where I'm at, where I'm traveling. I'm always checking y'all out on the YouTube, SoundCloud, wherever I can. So
that's what's up.
I'm a fan.
That's awesome. You do know that Sunday we're coming out with the compilation album.
Yes, I put that on my Facebook page and everything so everybody can see that. You know what I mean?
That's gonna be really good. I'm gonna tell you right now. That's gonna be really good. I don't care for the guy who's hosting it. I don't care for him. However, all the other artists on there, they are amazing, man. Next time you gotta get on it. You gotta get on the next one, man.
No, I'm gonna give y'all another artist that I got coming out too with me and whatnot. His name is Drew Paris.
Okay.
That's the next coming up, yeah, and he's coming up right behind me and whatnot. Y'all gonna love him.
Okay.
So we'll get y'all a single from him over there soon. Hold on, Drew. Speak up. Yeah. Hey, say something. He's sitting right here. I'm like, no, I'm giving him a shout out. Say something. Say what up.
What's going on, Drew Paris?
What's happening, Drew?
What up? How are you?
I'm good, man. How are you?
Chilling, you know, same old. Can't complain. I'm doing great.
Yay. Hey, we got to get that music from you. As soon as we get that music from you, you'll be doing a lot better. Trust me. I guarantee it.
For sure. I'm going to send it out as soon as possible.
Yeah, we're going to get that cheese this week because, yo, you got something called Gotta Love It that's beautiful. Y'all going. You're gonna flip on this, and then we got an album coming from him later on in the year.
Okay.
So, you guys, what I want to say to you guys, though, I must say thank you to you guys. Yo, Random Radio, when y'all put me in that Hall of Fame, when y'all was playing my joint, and then my album dropped, it was just so on time. Everything was, my streams are crazy, and I'm an indie artist. I'm way past 100,000.
That's what's up. That's so awesome. That is awesome. Yeah, that is
Random
awesome.
Random Radio definitely was giving me the first love, and yo, they helped blow this Culture Freedom thing a little bit out the box real quick.
Now, Culture Freedom, for those people who may not know who you are, that means they haven't been listening to the show. They're rude. So if they don't know who you are, tell the people out there, man, where are you from? Who is Culture Freedom? Go ahead, tell the people real quick. Give them a brief introduction of who you are, man.
It's Culture Freedom, Queens, New York. You know, I'm an OG. I've been rapping for over 25 years. I don't keep it. I'm an MC. I keep it OG real. I like being a 46-year-old MC. I don't put a lot of work in. I done been around the world 3 times. You know, hey, I've been across the country with this. I've been indie most of my entire career. Like, the only time I was signed basically was for a production deal when I was in my, like, 16, 17 years old. It was the only time I was officially signed. You know what I mean?
Uh-huh.
But I've been with some of the biggest artists, and then I learned the business, so I was able to keep an independent self since I was like putting out Mudface albums when I was in my group Mudfaces.
Mm-hmm.
We put out independent stuff when I was like 24, 25, 26, and so learning the business from that and selling hand to hand from out the trunk of the car, putting up posters at night, you know, getting them hands sticky and gluey and whatnot, it was real. So we learned this business, and that's where Culture Freedom came from, Mudfaces. From Mudfaces, I went solo. I went overseas to promote Mudfaces and got a solo production deal started with Detrimental Production. Mm-hmm. Then we put out another indie joint, which was Your Heart Movement, and then the new album, which is Equipped with Lyrics. Now, there's a 10-year hiatus between Your Heart Movement and Equipped with Lyrics.
Really?
Yeah, there's a 10-year hiatus because I did take some time off and I was just doing writing. But okay. A lot of people don't realize I was raising my sons, too.
Okay.
My son, yeah, they was playing football. So I was like, yo, I want to see this. You know what I mean?
I hear you.
Yeah, I took off that time and just really, I wanted to go to every game. I wasn't trying to miss nothing. I was trying to be daddy, not only just daddy, coach daddy. I was there.
That's
so
right.
I took that time off to really just focus on my sons and whatnot, just to watch them grow up. Word.
That's really, really good. That's really good to hear that, man. That's an awesome thing. I commend you for that. That's awesome, man.
Yeah, you know, the thing is, we put ourselves in a position like that. You know, right. The Mudface is being independent, then you had the publishing money from that and all the kind of things. When you're really independent, yo, there's a flow there. It can be a faucet, but you gotta create it.
Right.
You know what I mean? And then Your Heart Movement did its thing. Your Heart Movement was all over Europe just doing everything. Your Heart Movement, I mean, it put me on the map worldwide. I mean, it didn't smash in the United States because it was that sound that now they're doing now, like the Migos style, like the beats and stuff. Not lyrically, you know, the beat-wise, we were already there doing that kind of, because what they're doing is basically a mix of European jungle, what they call jungle in London, and bashment music. That's what they're basically doing. That's what those beats are.
Okay.
So it's a real fusion of London hip-hop with, and that's why I recorded Your Heart Movement in London. So I've been doing that for like 10 years before. With those beats you hear now, I was doing 10 years ago.
Okay.
But I was flipping the real lyrics on it. And now that Equipment Lyrics is doing so well as an album, people are listening to Your Heart Movement from the United States. And it's really, it's real interesting to see. But now they're like, wait a second, that album is crazy high. You know?
Right. That's awesome. That is awesome. That is a lot of history right there. Okay, so we have to play a song from you. We heard you brought a song today. We got to play this song, and then we're gonna jump into the reason that everybody is here. We're gonna have a little discussion about some things going on in the world. But what is the name of this song? Go ahead, Culture Freedom. Introduce this song to the world, man, that you brought to us today. We're gonna cue it up, and then we're gonna pick Culture Freedom's brain. But you go ahead, cue this up, man.
All right, there you go. This song right here is from the album Equipped with Lyrics, available now, iTunes, Spotify, everywhere. We got to do that. You know what I'm saying? I see fire. And it's, you just listen to the words. And it's basically what it says. I see fire. And I do mean it every single syllable. I write from the heart, you know? And I like to write from a perspective, because I'm a warrior for the people. I work for my people. So I'm here for y'all. Awesome. All right? I See Fire, check it out. I know y'all gonna love this because it's for y'all.
Alright, this is I See Fire. Culture Freedom, Random Radio.
Yesterday, before votes were tallied, I shot a video that some of you may have seen in which I said to the American people, regardless of which side you were on in the election, the sun would come up in
the morning. Cops killing my people can't last forever. So if I die today, I guess we die together. I heard that man scream out, I can't breathe. But them homicidal pigs gave him no reprieve. Now we all gon' burn, cause the POTA made the block hot. It's okay to kill our brothers, then don't cry when there's a cop shot. Possible to conceive, or even to believe. You think you kill our people and we take the shit with ease?
I see fire in my people's eyes. I see fire. We tired of all the lies. I see fire. My people on the rise. I see fire.
Okay.
I can hear the children crying.
When I spit truth, they say I'm unpatriotic. If you think I give a fuck, then you straight psychotic. If the night gon' fall, then we all gon' grab it. But there's still more of us, that's just eyeball mathematics. The policeman push, cause they arrogant devils. Plus I not think that the people them gon' rebel. But I keep you on the level, yo, that shit's not true. Let them bodies keep falling, it's gon' do what it do.
I see fire in my people's eyes. I see fire. We tired of all the lies. I see fire. My people on the rise. I see fire.
children cry.
I'ma give you facts. These corporations make stacks, incarcerating blacks and losing niggas in the cracks. All for a buck, we get more fucked inside of me. Like we was made to feed the prison cottage economy. But everything is fine, cause everybody making dimes. From the cracker on the top to niggas kicking gangster rhymes. The whole world believe our DNA was made for crime, but this is by design, so I'ma pray for mine.
I see fire. In my people's eyes, I see fire. We tired of all the lies. I see fire. My people want to rise. I see fire. I can hear the children crying. I see fire. I see fire. I see fire.
See fire.
I see fire
in my people's eyes.
Lorenzo Tomas here to talk to you about Random Radio Video Show. Random Radio Video Show is the only place on the planet that is playing all unsigned independent artist videos for free on our format called the Random Radio Video Show. It doesn't matter if you have hip hop, rock, rap, EDM. I feel like I've done this before. Just send your videos to rrpshow@gmail.com. The same way you send your music in for the podcast, it's the same way you send your music in for the video show. Don't hesitate. Do it right now, man. We playing all videos all the time. Subscribe to our channel, Random Radio Podcast Show. Make sure you do that today. Random Radio Video Show, rrpshow@gmail.com. Send those videos in today. Hey, Random Radio.
Do your mixes sound flat and lifeless? Does the crack of your snares hurt every time you turn your music up? Are your 808s floppy and lacking the bass you just know they should have? If so, it's time for you to hit up Artis Music Engineering to get your next single radio ready. Artis Music is a Pensado Award-nominated, full-service mixing and mastering company dedicated to making your song sound just as good as the pros. It doesn't matter if your music is hip-hop, pop, rock, EDM, or bluegrass. Artis Music will take your mix to the next level, allowing it to compete on an equal playing field with today's hits. So what are you waiting for? Contact us at www.soundcloud.com/artismusicengineering and get your singles sounding like hits today.
Hey, Lorenzo Tomas here to talk to you about Bite the Nickel Radio Show, one of the hottest international internet radio shows in the Midwest. Based out of Indianapolis, Indiana, with the world-class DJ Martu Lamar Moore and his co-host Dario DeBarber, helping local, statewide, and international underground artists get heard. Known in 23 states and 23 countries, if you need help promoting your music, your brand, this is the radio station to be on. In order to submit music, here's what you gotta do. Send two of your best tracks, must be in MP3 format, type at least a paragraph bio of yourself, send pictures of album or mixtape of yourself, all social sites that you rock with, and please, no zip folders. For further information, contact Martu Morehouse at Facebook. We have the link on our page. You can check it out there. What are you waiting on? Submit your music today. Make sure you tell them that Random Radio sent you too. If you haven't done so yet, go follow us on Twitter at RRP Show. That's at RRP Show. Twitter at RRP Show. Random Radio Discussion Show. Different from the podcast show, but the same. Make sure you guys go and check out that Random Radio podcast show up every Sunday at midnight, featuring some of the hottest brand new music all around the world. Today we have an artist from the Random Radio podcast show. This is Culture Freedom. You heard his song earlier. That was I See Fire. We now have Culture Freedom. He's going to talk some social issues today. So, you know what, Culture Freedom? Let's go around the board and see what do we have on the topic board for the day. Let's take a look. First on the list is, well, apparently... we have the Black Panther trailer. That's first. What do you feel about the Black Panther trailer, that movie? Have you heard of that?
Okay, yes, I have. Here's what I feel about that. I have no problem with it, to be honest with you. You know what I mean? I think Black... At the end of the day, right, it's one of those situations that when we want to control the entire entity from A to Z, we have to control the entire entity from A to Z. You can't keep going in other people's houses telling them how you want them to put the pictures on the wall. Mm-hmm. But you get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So you sort of got to take the pictures on the wall the way they're putting it. You know, and I know it's a harsh reality, but that is reality.
Okay.
And so what I'm trying to tell black people, when you wanted to be the Black Panther like the movie you wanted to be, you got to make that movie.
Right.
You gotta put all the money up from A to Z. You gotta own the production. And guess what? You gotta own the character too. That's a Marvel character.
And that's my thing. It's a Marvel character. So I don't see why they can't make the movie and how Marvel, if Marvel's affiliated, they can make the movie how they wanna make it. They can do what they want with their character.
That's right. That's right. And it's not like we don't have enough talented people in our community that's doing comic books right now. I know a sister that's doing comic books right now, that she's on the internet, on Facebook and all of that, and she's doing all these wonderful comics. We could pick one of her characters and make a much more dynamic movie than anything Marvel could ever come up with. Look at who we are. We made the waves when they was doing The Wizard of Oz. Mm-hmm. Which one you watch today? Mm-hmm. Let's keep it real.
That's true. I mean that's true. All right, so how about this? How about this topic here? Mr. Donald Trump, our president, is mocking the Vice President Mike Pence. What is going on here? What is happening here? What are your thoughts on Donald Trump in general? What's going on here? I guess this would lead us into the next topic, which would be that Colin Kaepernick is filing a lawsuit against the NFL for collusion.
Woo! Well, let's get to Donald Trump first and the Mike Pence situation. So you have the president mocking his vice president.
This is true. This is very true. Now I don't know the context of what the mocking was about. I believe that it is over something.
I saw the breaking story earlier. I was watching MSNBC right before we got into the conversation. So I saw the breaking story.
Okay.
If you look at the entire administration, even with this story that's just breaking, right? This is a continuation. And it's not only a continuation of Donald Trump's presidency, it's a continuation of how he ran his television show. If you would listen and read the stuff that was going on behind the scenes, if you look at how he ran his real estate, but I live in New York. So when they talk about Donald Trump is a great real estate icon, that's all fake. He's never really done anything that he said he was going to do. He was supposed to build up the West Side, never happened. So he was able to curl core land, sit on the land for years, and then resell it back for like triple and quadruple the rate.
Okay.
Donald Trump is a con man, and he conned the nation. But we here in New York, we're mostly up to date on him because we've seen what he did with the kids from Central Park. He's always made these racial kind of statements. His father, Fred Trump, is a known racist here in New York.
Mm-hmm.
So it's not like, I'm still at a point of, if this can happen in the United States, we have to reassess our moves as black people.
What do you mean by Donald Trump has always made racist statements? Do you mean like statements against African Americans or statements against people in general?
When I say racist statements, when we say African American, I'm talking about black, brown, red, and yellow.
Okay.
All people, you know, all of us, because we all share the same thing. We might not understand it, but we all share the same condition. You understand? So regardless of whether we want to see each other as brothers and sisters, whether you speak Spanish, French, whatever African language, whatever Asian or Chinese language, I do understand condition.
Okay.
And we share the same condition. Whether you in Saudi Arabia right now and you're a frustrated child in Arabian Peninsula, you got the same person's foot on your neck that I got on my neck.
Okay, so what has Donald Trump said that's racist against African Americans?
When he took out a full-page ad in New York Times and he was ready to convict these young 14-year-old black men, mm-hmm. who was five, seven of them. I went to Central Park Five. I went to school with him too, his sister. I actually dated one of their sisters when I was in high school, because
mm-hmm.
it happened at the time when I was in high school, and they were supposed to have been quote-unquote wilding in the park, and they attacked a white woman. They didn't do it.
Okay.
It was all fake. They didn't do it. But Donald Trump had took out a ad in the New York, a full page in all of the New York newspapers, convicting them of this crime, how they animals and need to be locked under a prison. and these young black males need to be brought under control. You know, codified crack language. You know, for lack of a better term, that's what it is.
Okay.
We have to be able to break that down when they're saying terms of black. This today, we're going to make America great again. Who do we?
Let me ask this about the Central Jogger case. So the that situation, you know, Donald Trump was hasty and he made a poor choice in doing that. When the case finally came out, those young men were obviously they were not guilty of that crime. However, Donald Trump made a mistake. Is that racism, or is that Donald Trump just jumping to conclusions?
Okay, let's look at the history of that. So you got the Central Park case.
Mm-hmm.
Then you have the slum landlord cases that he had in New York.
Okay.
He was accused, him and his son, all right, accused of being slum landlords here in New York. They somehow beat that case.
Okay.
I'm going to talk about what specifically affects people of color, so we can once you see an observation, if the stars are moving in a certain direction, we got to map that out, right? Then we understand how the stars move and what's really going on from a bigger picture.
Let's map it out.
I guess what I'm trying to understand
is, how is Donald Trump racist? What I hear is, okay, with the slum lord case, what's that?
He has a continued pattern of behavior that is racist, or let's say behavior that is poor toward people of color. A continued pattern that goes back over 30 years.
Okay, I've heard the slum lord case.
When your father is a card-carrying member of the KKK, was arrested.
Well, that's never been proven. That is a rumor, and that has never been proven.
They have the actual arrest record here. They put it in the newspaper. His father was arrested on that day, all right, in New Jersey, as a part of a riot that was a Klansman riot in New Jersey.
Right, it was a Klansman riot, but they didn't say that he was a member of the Klan during the riot. That's not what was said. He was arrested. Okay. That is true. He was arrested, and he was at a Klan riot.
He was there, and he was arrested with Klansmen. We can leave it at that.
He was arrested. There were many people arrested with Klansmen. Just because you're white and you were there in the middle of a fight doesn't mean you're a part of the Klan. You could have been on the opposing side, and you could have been arrested with the Klan that way. However, that's his father. Back to Donald Trump. So Donald Trump was a slumlord. Wait a minute. Hold on. Wait a minute. Donald Trump was a slumlord. Well, here in Chicago, there are many projects that have existed. In Chicago, Henry Horner Homes, Ida B. Wells, those at one point were created for World War II veterans. Then eventually African Americans took up the majority of those locations, and then they were treated poorly over time. Would you call all of the aldermen who also were African American in some of those communities, they were racist to those blacks because the areas became slumly?
No, what you have is you have a system, right? And see, here's where the ultimate goes to. Donald Trump has a history, right? But Donald Trump's history is not alone to Donald Trump. I'm not saying that. I'm not saying that it's alone to him. But when you run for president of all of the people, you have to represent all of the people. We saw what that looks like with Barack Obama.
Do you think Barack Obama represented all of the people in the White House?
He did his best to represent the all, and that's why he was criticized by black people, because they thought he was going to go in there and be Huey P. Newton. But that's not what he could be, because that's not what he was elected to be. That's not never what you're elected to be when you're president. When you're elected to be president, you have to be president of all. So me personally, I would not run for president, because I'm going to take care of my black, brown, red, and yellow brothers and sisters.
Why is that? Why is it that you would care more about taking care of the African-American race versus taking care of everyone so that we all could be harmonious together?
Let's be clear. I said black, brown, red, and yellow, because once again, I don't tie myself to an American thing. I'm a part of the African diaspora.
But no white people. So no white people would receive any assistance.
I'm not saying that either. What I'm saying is, I am a part of the African diaspora.
Okay.
I have to. It would be ignorant of me not to.
Okay.
Not take care of myself and that which is of myself.
Okay.
And when that is which is of myself, when this river is clean and this river, and I'm not, I don't point to anyone because I don't think it's not an outside job. This is an inside job. And this is what I think the Donald Trump presidency can teach black people the most. This is an inside job because things are being made very clear. If you cannot see the clarity of this moment, then you will never see the clarity of, and it may not be for you. But me personally, the resonance of this situation has brought me to the understanding of myself. It is going to only take me to get me out of this because these people have not set up a system that has concern for me. And anybody who says they has, then that you got to walk with that. I'm not walking that way anymore.
You don't believe that America has set up opportunities for African Americans? It's only opportunities
America is not concerned with black, brown, red, and yellow people, period.
What about white people? Are they concerned with them?
I'm not concerned with that. I know that when it comes to my black, brown, red, and yellow people.
Wait. You are an American, right? You are an American, right?
I was born in a place called America.
So you're not.
I adhere to a culture of the West because I am born in the West.
So are you an American? Are you an American? No,
I'm a divine presence.
You're not an American.
I'm a divine presence.
You're not an American.
I am a divine presence.
Well, it's a divine presence and an American are two different things. God is a divine presence, but I don't think that God is an American because
I come here and I represent in divine presence. I can't represent for something that is totally, it's obvious.
So you're not an American.
I'm a divine presence, brother. I am here and I represent divine presence.
So are you an American? Yes or no? Are you an American?
Divine presence. I don't know what an American represents.
An American is a person who lives in America, is a citizen of America.
No, that's not what an American is. America is an idea. The land itself doesn't say America. If I take a plane and I go in here, I can't look down and see the word America.
Okay, United.
It's an idea. Okay. It's an idea. What does that idea represent? And what are you asking me to call myself?
I am asking you, are you an American citizen?
I'm telling you, I was born within the confines of the boundaries of what we know as America, and okay. by that, I am an American citizen.
Okay. Let me ask you this. Are you happy in America? Do you enjoy being here?
No. Listen, I'm happy within myself, and this is what I'm trying to lead the people here. The brother, right. We don't need to pick up a mad revolution. We don't need to be angry with anyone. Mm-hmm. We need to redirect our attention to ourselves, to a greater being that is already existing within ourselves, because that's where freedom is at. It does not lie in Donald Trump's hands. It has never lied in any of their hands.
Right.
You have moved these people into this mystified divine force that is outside of you.
Right. That's understandable.
These people are not gods.
Right. That's understandable.
And at this point, these people are doing things that people do. Power mm-hmm. does not concede. Mm-hmm. And these people, let's just get down to the nitty gritty of it. You want people to love you, that if they loved you, they wouldn't exist anymore. Do you think they're really going to do that?
What do you mean? I don't understand what you mean by that. What do you mean by
love
that?
Them. Let's just get to the point. Let's get to the real what this is. Mm-hmm. What this is, white and black, is a genetic warfare. Okay? Love will erase them.
Right.
It's just genetics, brother. So what you got to do is you got to see the truth. So okay. If I'm numb, it's like being a puddle, right? Mm-hmm. And you're a puddle and all of this on a black road, right? Mm-hmm. And the black road has a dent in it. And you're this puddle of water and the sun is shining. And you know that the future holds for you as a puddle of water, that you are going to evaporate. That's the bottom line. That black car is going to be around you and it's going to stay forever. Because that's just how it works. It's just nature. I am not making this up. Nature made this.
Okay.
If they were to love you, they would not be here. What do you think the tiki torches is about? What do you think is, what are they saying? We will not be erased. Because what has happened in America, let's talk about it for real, is Barack Obama and the image that he left behind scared them and shook them so much.
Scared who?
It shook them to the core.
Scared who?
It shook those who believe in their genetic annihilation. And these are people
who is
themselves.
This that believes people, in a genetic annihilation? People, who are these people?
People who consider themselves white.
People who consider themselves who?
People who consider themselves white human beings. Because this is an idea.
Okay.
White is not a reality. It's an idea, once again.
Okay, so people who consider themselves white are trying to do genetic annihilation?
Listen to me. Let's just keep it real. You have a pink rose and you have a white rose. They come together, they're going to make another kind of pink rose. It's called genetic. This is recessive gene.
So right? You think
they
that
have a recessive gene, brother. So you it's think so they you, have a recessive gene. Okay?
So you think that white people
I understand what it listen to what they are saying. They are telling you how they feel.
You're gonna have to give me some examples of white people wanting to genetically take black people off the planet. Cause I don't hear this. I don't see this. I'm seeing white people fighting white people over racism for African Americans. Now I do see blacks killing blacks in my city in the droves. Tons of blacks are dying every day. But I do not see whites killing blacks in my city.
And listen to what I'm saying. If we had and this is what I'm telling those people in your city, right now in Chicago, the brothers and sisters who are killing one another, if we don't redirect our attention back to our spiritual self, in ourselves,
well, those people don't care about that. Essentially, cultural freedom, those people aren't concerned about that. They're concerned about something else.
We have to make them care about it. We have to push them back
you,
to themselves.
Well, you can't force people to care about things that they have never been exposed to or they've never cared about before.
If people cannot care about themselves, how can they care about anything else?
They won't. They don't care about themselves. Honestly, culture freedom, a lot of these young men are growing up without fathers, so they don't even have any guidance to begin with.
A lot of them are growing up with fathers.
Excuse me?
So let's focus on those who are growing up with the fathers and start to build that
The ones who are growing up with fathers, they're typically not having these kind of problems, culture freedom. It's really the ones who are growing up without fathers who are the ones who are more violent. Many of the cases in Chicago alone with individual adolescents who are getting caught with guns and getting gun charges and drug charges and abuse charges. When I say abuse, I don't mean sexual abuse. I mean like abuse, assault. They don't have fathers. They are growing up in single parent homes. So,
I grew up.
What'd you say?
Yeah. Go ahead, Drew. I grew up in a single parent home.
Well, and I understand it. And I'm not saying that 100% across the board. I'm not saying 100% across the board.
Personally, if you ask me, I really think it's our culture. That's what I'm saying. Attack it at a culture. It's a culture. That's why my name is Culture Freedom. It's only culture.
Here's a problem with the culture of African Americans. Here's one big problem with the culture of African Americans. Part of it is that we have constantly been told some of the similar things that I'm hearing here, that some of the issues that with us start with issues that are outside of us. When a lot of the problems with African Americans,
I never said that.
I understand.
I specifically was clear. No. I'm specifically clear, and I say it again. None of our problems have to do with anybody else. It doesn't have to do with another community. I made that very clear, and I'll make it clear again.
Okay.
We need an inside telescope. This is an inside job. I will be very clear.
Caucasians,
white people, whatever you want to call them, the people from Europe are not your problem. They are not the originator of your problem. They are the resonance to make you better.
Okay. I apologize, Culture Freedom, because you know what? You did say that, and I must have misheard you. So I apologize for that. You're correct.
Brother, my point only is this. We are at an important shift and juncture in the existence of African people globally. I don't look at myself as just here.
Mm-hmm.
We are global people, and globally, we are enduring the same condition. So why should I small in my mind to put my mind to
Where else are African people being? Where else do you see this oppression? And what is this oppression that these African people are suffering from? I don't know what it is.
The oppression of forgetfulness.
What are people forgetting?
You forgot who you are. You have oppressed yourself.
Essentially, in many Caucasian families, many Jewish families, many Asian families, many Mexican families, they keep up with their traditional values. The problem with African American families and many other Caucasian families, because I will say many Caucasian families have also lost sight of their heritage, because we're Americans, because we live here, we believe that this is the heritage, and we have embraced this culture as our heritage.
Now, if we continue to embrace an American culture without making it grow, without changing it to adapt to who we are as a people.
Are we not doing that?
We are not doing that.
How are we not doing that? How are we not doing that with all the legislation being passed for various different things?
We may interject musically and through entertainment, right? But we need to inject in a different kind of way.
Well, how are we not with all the legislation that's being passed for things for people?
I'm not talking about legislation. See, once again, those are outside entities. Those things will not change brothers and sisters shooting each other on the street in Chicago, brother.
So what would you suggest? What would you suggest to help those in Chicago?
In Chicago specifically, what we need to do is those of us who know, you got to go in and embrace. You got to touch.
What do you mean by that?
Those of us who know, if there's 10 of us who are down and we know, we got to walk those streets and embrace.
What do you mean by that? Be more specific. Okay. That's a little vague.
Okay,
be more specific.
Me and Drew are sitting here. We in Staten Island. And in Staten Island, we got a pill program, right? Like a pill problem. There's a very bad opiate problem in our community.
Okay.
All right? In order for me to go out there and change that amongst my people, I got to go out there and touch these people, talk to them. I got to be on the street with them. I got to let them see me and feel me. And I got to present an alternative to them at that's right in front of their face. And at that point, what I might have to do is those who are going to listen to me, even if it's just one per week, if I can get them to a program, I got to walk them in that door. I got to make that kind of commitment to myself. Because it's not a commitment to him. It's truly a commitment to myself. Because if I get him off the street,
so essentially what I'm hearing is the pill problem in Staten Island is there's an opiate problem. And you think that it would be best to go walk the streets, find people who have opiate problems and who want help. I'm assuming you're finding people who want help.
And you would take them. Whether it's the opiate problem, whether it's the weed, we have to address it hands on ourselves.
Okay, so
it's
so
not gonna come
so
from the government budget.
So in kids, so and I
money. But how are you talking to your kids?
And I can see that working. I can see that working in if people want to get help. In Chicago, however, how do you solve that problem? What would you do to fix that problem?
Yo, let me tell you something. What we do to fix that problem is the same thing that we've always done as black people, embrace our people. We can't be scared of our own people. Ever.
So wait a minute. If children are running around, like, and I really do mean children, I mean under the age of 18. If children are running around with guns, shooting random people, how do you target them to show them some love? What do you do for them? How are you supposed to target them? And what is...
Let me tell you something, brother. You got to walk up to him. Say, yo, young man, your life means something.
What about jail? You don't think jail would work for these individuals?
No. Has jail worked? Has it worked?
I believe that jail has worked for some, and jail doesn't work for many.
If we were putting people into institutions like in Cuba and re-educating them, that would be different. But the jail is not a university here.
Jails were not created for re-education. Jails were created for you to change your behavior out in the outside, and so you could be better on the outside world.
How do they do that, brother? They do that by going in there, and then they terrify brothers with the threat of rape and all that kind of stuff. So you're supposed
Wait a minute. The warden and the governor and they're not threatening anybody with rape. That's the inmates inside. So if the people inside of the jungle are acting like animals, wouldn't you not want to go back to the jungle?
Listen to me. As a former correction officer in the state of Georgia, I did this job for over a year.
Okay.
The correctional services, the officers, and the wardens use rape as an umbrella of threat.
The warden is raping people?
No. They will put inmates in certain situations where they know certain things can happen.
Okay.
Okay? They will put inmates that they can't control around predators.
To control them, correct?
To control them. You understand?
Is that,
be honest about the system we live in.
What would you suggest is a better way to, now I understand that this may not be the best ways to control unstable inmates. What do you suggest is the best way to control an unstable inmate if you can't threaten them?
Let me tell you something. The best way to control anybody before they become an inmate is if you deal with it before they become one.
How do you do that if you can't? You can't do that if you have all these children growing up with single families.
As many times as we say we can't, then we won't come up with the idea.
You can't because these...
It's
not the idea of we can't culture freedom. It's not working. None of these problems are working. Here in Chicago, what they said in the 80s is it's the school system. The school system hasn't gotten better because of teachers unions and CPS. That has not helped kids. They have gotten dumber. The illiteracy rate has gotten higher. Wait a minute. Hold on, culture freedom. Many people have said, oh, we need less policing. So when you have less policing, that creates more crime. Because when criminals know that there are less police on the street, they do more criminal activity. So I'm trying to figure out, if none of these solutions have been working, don't you think that if you have states where there are tons of, where there's not as much crime, like Alabama, for instance, and they're very strict on how they deal with criminals, or Indiana, for instance, which is right next door, Lake County deals very hard on juvenile offenses. If you keep finding juveniles with guns, does it make sense to just keep letting them go back out so they can get more guns? Or lock them up to rehabilitate them so that they can be better? Because the adjudication process for juveniles is not the same as it is for...
I mean, what you're talking about is if we want to continue a cycle of where we're at now, right? And then we want to keep saying that the systems that are in place now that haven't served us well for the last 300-400 years are automatically, somehow, subsequently just appearing to serve us all of a sudden because we're going to feed them more of our children, right? That's what you're saying. Just keep giving them to the system, all right? If these systems are what you
if being in the house isn't working, what else should they do, culture freedom? You got to do something.
Well, let me explain to you. If these systems aren't working, then let's try something new. What I'm telling you, as a black people, as a people of African descent, try your own culture. The answer is already there.
I don't know what that means, and we are running out of time. I enjoyed this conversation so much. You gotta call back, and we'll do it again. Culture Freedom, if people wanna find you, where do they find you, man? How do they get in touch with you if they wanna, you know, have some of your music, or maybe if even they wanna talk to you about some of these subjects that we talked about today? How do they get in touch with you, man?
You can get in touch with me at Facebook, Culture Freedom, Equipped with Lyrics is my Facebook tag. So you just put in Culture Freedom, Equipped with Lyrics, you hit me on Facebook. I'm at Culture Freedom on Twitter. I'm at Culture Freedom on Instagram. Hit me up on the gram, anything, any questions you have, anything, we can discuss further. This is what I go into in my music, you know, the mind, focusing on oneself. Because if you can perfect yourself, then nothing outside of you is going to be able to address you in any kind of harmful way. And you have a culture as a people of Kemetic descent, a people of African descent that teaches this. It's not a mystery. It's right in front of your face. All you got to do is open a book, hit a Google. It's so in front of your face now. It is very available. Your freedom is at your fingertips. Your finger is within. Your freedom is within you. It has nothing to do with anybody else. You got to get on a new plan.
That's what's
and
up.
And that has to be internal.
That's what's up. Culture Freedom. Make sure you guys check out Culture Freedom's information everywhere. Culture Freedom. Before I let you go, Culture Freedom, did you have fun, man? Did you enjoy yourself?
I had a great time. This was a great conversation. I love to do it again. Yeah, I got more joints coming next year. You're going to see a new album. Look out for Duke Harris's new album. He's about to drop his joints. And you can check Duke Harris on Spotify, too. Duke's up there as well. So check us out. We're going to see a whole clique of us coming. Intelligent black men. We love to have these kind of conversations. These are the kind of conversations we need to try to bring more unity and understanding to our community so we can make a change for tomorrow. Because we can. We are great now.
That's right. That's right. We're about to take a break. Culture Freedom is gonna, you know, be on Random Radio many more times. We're going to take a break. We'll be back after this. And it's Random Radio Discussion.
Hi everyone, this is Lola. I'm here to talk about the Random Radio Podcast Compilation Album. The Random Radio Podcast Compilation Album features some of the greatest rappers that have been played on Random Radio Podcast Show. It also features my song, Body.
I know you want my body, put your body on my body. I know you want my body, put got your body, like my body, like my body, baby. My body, baby.
Random Radio compilation album is up right now on SoundCloud and YouTube. Go listen to it today. You won't be sorry. And you're listening to Random Radio.
Lorenzo Tomas here for Royal Skating Apparel. Royal Skating Apparel is where I get all of my skating gear. I don't go nowhere else. And also, I go and check out their weekly showcases where they have all music of all kinds there, and they let these artists perform and get down all the time. Now, if you're interested in hitting up Royal Skating Apparel, make sure you go to 3429 Ridge Road in Lansing, Illinois. That is 3429 Ridge Road in Lansing, Illinois. Or you can always hit up GJ at 708-297-4596. That's 708-297-4596. Or you can go to their Facebook page at facebook.com/RoyalSNA. Royal Skating and Apparel. Tell them Random Radio sent you.
Before we watch TV or even check the news, before you brush your teeth, before you wash your cooch, before you call your friends or cook the kids some food, there's something I want to give to you.
Audio by Phil Cat. Go listen to it now on SoundCloud.
All day, all day, all day, all day, all day. We have sex, girl, all day.
If you haven't done it yet, go like us on Facebook. That's right, facebook.com/RRP Show. facebook.com/RRP Show. facebook.com/RRP Show. Make sure you guys check out Culture Freedom. He is going to be everywhere. He's always on Random Radio. And he's got music everywhere. Check out his Facebook page. We'll have the link to his Facebook page on our Facebook page. This is Random Discussion. If you feel like you want to leave some comments in the bottom, you want to chime in on some of the things we were saying, leave some comments in the bottom. We are exclusively on YouTube, so you can always come back and listen to us anytime. All right, we'll see you next week. I'll have a different person. We might have, you know, some similar discussions. Either way, if you want to sign up for a Random Discussion, you want to be on, you want to talk to me, you want to argue with me, you want to be mad at me, that's fine. Hit us up at rrpshow@gmail.com and sign up there. It's free. Costs you nothing. All right. Random Radio Discussion, Random Radio Podcast Show every Sunday. Make sure you guys go check that out. Send your music to rrpshow@gmail.com. I'm going to see you guys later. This is Random Discussion. This is Random Radio.
You are listening to Random Radio.